seen them.
We assume they're about marriage.
You could also do Proud Mary.
Yeah, we could do that one.
Roll it, roll it, roll it on the river. Shirley, on Praise to the Lord, how much are you going to play?
I can't hear you.
What are you gonna play for the intro on Praise to the Lord, just the first?
The first phrase is the procedure for choirs.
Okay, Praise to the Lord, the Almighty Creator, King of Creation.
Yeah.
That whole thing.
I did it right up to the word nation, creation.
Creation.
Good morning and welcome to St. Ambrose. Let us sing together Praise to the Lord, number 207.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I have heard very little from Father Albert about how things are going over there. He did send a couple of pictures of him and a brother or two of his with their father in the hospital. But that was several days ago, and haven't heard anything since. I suppose that that means nothing bad, one hopes. We remember, of course, Father Albert and his family in our prayers as we celebrate the Eucharist this day, this Sunday. And let us also recall the burdens that are being carried by people who are suffering from fires in Hawaii and other places, and war and violence of any kind. Let us lift all of them up in our prayers. And now let's acknowledge our own need for healing and forgiveness, and so prepare our hearts to hear the word of God and celebrate the wondrous mystery of God's love. O Lord Jesus, you came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to call all of us who are sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give us your very self to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, you have taught us by the Holy Spirit, and so we dare to call you our Father. Bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response, "Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation."
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
I will hear what the Lord proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
Kindness and truth shall meet. Justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ. I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs. And from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
According to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus had fed the people, he made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It may surprise you, but probably not, that sometimes I have a hard time coming up with an idea for a homily. Sometimes I ask our little Monday night group for help, and sometimes they do, and sometimes they don't. But when I'm really getting back to basics, I remember a little rule that a scripture scholar taught me a long time ago. And his rule is, look for how Jesus himself exemplifies what's happening in the event or what is intended by the parable. Where is Jesus in the parable or in the event? Not simply at the surface, he's telling the parable or he's part of the event, but what does it mean? I did that a couple of weeks ago when I suggested that the parable of the treasure found in the field could be about the way Jesus treasures us enough to give up everything to gain our love for him, to secure our eternal life with him. We are the treasure, and God's own Son is the excited finder. Our opening prayer and the Alleluia verse that we sang have something in common. They point to what has happened to us through baptism into the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus. The Sunday celebration to which the church invites us and actually obliges us to participate in, you know that this Sunday worship of ours is in thanksgiving for the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. In thanksgiving, meaning of the word Eucharist is thanksgiving, and we celebrate this on the day of the resurrection. We're not obliged to go most other days, but on Sunday, the church calls us together because of the resurrection of Jesus. Every Sunday for us is an Easter Sunday. But the celebration, the Sunday celebration, is not just a commemoration of the historical event of the resurrection, as important as that is. It is the celebration of what grace, God's grace, is working in us as we have come to believe and are coming to believe more fully in Jesus as God's own Son and our Savior. My good friend, Sister Mary Catherine, whom I mentioned a couple of weeks ago to pat her on the back for her wisdom and teaching skill, he opened my eyes to the deep meaning of the resurrection by pointing out to me that the risen Lord Jesus is the light of the world. And when we say Jesus is the light of the world, we mean Jesus risen from death. He is risen now and will never be anything but risen from death. And when Jesus says to us, "You are the light of the world," he means that it's because we belong to him and share his life. Anyway, the light of the old, the light of the resurrection, is a pervading light that illumines what we call the Old Testament. It is a light that reveals in the Old Testament the handiwork of God that God was doing during centuries before his son was born as Jesus in Bethlehem. The light of the resurrection reveals all that happened in the Old Testament as the preparation necessary to get a tiny little family ready for Jesus to be born into. All of the Old Testament was leading up to, God was working through the Old Testament to create a little nest in Nazareth where Jesus could grow and become obedient to his parents and increase in wisdom and age and grace before God and other people. If it were not for the resurrection, we would not have that view of the Old Testament. I'm coming back to what that scripture scholar told me about seeking the place of Jesus in today's gospel. After Jesus had fed the 5,000 with a few loaves of bread and a couple of fish, he sent the disciples ahead of him to the other side of the big lake. He dismissed the crowd and went alone to be with the Father in prayer. He prays quite a long time, and when he's done, he can see a storm has descended on the lake. And he goes to them, walking on the lake, because he can, and because they are in need. He speaks to the flabbergasted disciples to allay their fears, and then, because Peter is talking to the apparition and says, if you are really you, Jesus invites Peter to take a walk in faith. When Peter's faith falters, Jesus holds him up with his strong arm and accompanies Peter back into the boat. Those in the boat honor him, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. Jesus has brought them, by means of that, to a new and deeper faith in him. He accomplishes that aspect of his mission, the walking on the water and the calming of the storm serve to strengthen and deepen the faith of the disciples. But wait, there's more. Look once more with me at what God was doing, preparing a world into which God's own Son could be born into. The baby, the boy, the son of Mary, the foster child of her husband Joseph, the young man who was altogether human in the eyes of his contemporaries. This one is the Son of God. And he not only walks on the water in this stunning revelation to his disciples. In a matter of weeks or months, Jesus allows himself to be sent to the deep place of death, drowned in the waves of hatred and envy and the malice of those who killed him. We say in the Apostles' Creed, he descended into hell, we say. But it is not the hell of the damned. It is the place that holds all the bodies of the dead. Into Jesus descended into death. And on the third day, he rose from the dead. That's where our salvation is. As the disciples, soaked with what could have been the waters of death, were it not for Jesus, as the disciples see the power of Jesus over the water, the winds, and the waves, they will, finally, after his resurrection, come to believe in him in a way that could make them martyrs, witnesses to the truth of the resurrection with their own blood. The resurrection of Jesus is our hope. And not only or after our death. Jesus, fulfilling the will of the Father, trusting himself to the Father's loving and powerful care, shows us by his resurrection what it means to believe. May we all have our own faith in him strengthened and deepened each day. Let's stand together now and profess our faith. And let's not be in too much of a hurry. That part in the middle that is kind of the major section of the creed, it's all about Jesus. It's all about what God was doing in preparing the world for him, how he laid down his life for us and took it up again. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let's offer our prayers now with confidence in God.
For the church, may the hand of the Lord already steady each of us across any storm waters as we serve as one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government officials, may God grant them the conviction and the ability to work for justice for all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are facing a trial of faith, may the Lord's gentle whisper and guiding hand be upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God give us the grace to follow him in all things. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they rest in eternal peace in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our book of intentions and those calling and requesting prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister's diocese in Lidward, Kenya, our sister parish in Guatemala, and our St. Ambrose parish family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Beth McElhone, Sue Chickvera, for healing, and for Father Albert, for his safe return to us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Ronnie Muchler and Julia Caesar Millers, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's invite our Blessed Mother's intercession as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As we present our gifts, let us sing together, Lead Me, Guide Me, number 402. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you.
fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We eat this bread and drink this cup. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our beloved brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command and formed by Jesus' own divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer one another some sign of peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As we receive our Lord in Holy Communion, let us sing together Bread of Life, number 355.
Bread of life, hope of the world.
A special thank you to our funeral luncheon coordinators and the many other volunteers who helped us set up, serve, clean up last Friday. The family of Tom and Bernie Phelps are very grateful, and so are we. The 2023-24 religious education school year begins on Sunday, September 10th at 10 a.m. in the parish hall. Come and meet your catechist and register for the new school year. Coffee and donuts will be available. Included in the St. Ambrose Summer Fall newsletter sent out last week was a volunteer sign-up sheet for 2024. Please take a few moments and let us know what you can do to help your parish grow. Remember, love grows where people serve. Thank you. The Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary is this Tuesday, August 15th. This is a holy day of obligation. Our parish mass will be celebrated at 6 p.m. We hope to see you there. Have a blessed week.
Let's stand and pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we've consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Let us sing together, though the mountains may fall. Number 437.
As we fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand as a shelter for all who will call on his name, sing the praise and the glory of God. Could the Lord forget his own? Though a mother forsake her child, he will not abandon you. Though the mountains may fall and the
the hills turn to dust, let the love of the Lord descend as a shelter for all. Should you want